has been called the greatest living calligrapher. In his more than 45-year career, Hasan Masoudi has pushed the limits of the ancient art form with his contemporary approach. Masoudi is back with his latest book, Calligraphies of the Desert. He was born in Najaf, Iraq, a city on the edge of the desert. Through his brush strokes, he tries to depict its breathtaking beauty and wonder. Along the way, he draws inspiration from the words of poets and writers such as Rumi, Goethe, and Khalil Gibran. Let's talk to curator, writer, and producer Rose Issa. Hi, Rose. Good to have you back on our show. So, I just said that he's been called the greatest living calligrapher. What would you say to that? Do you think he actually is the greatest living calligrapher?
I find those adjective a little bit over the top, because you have to know a lot of other calligraphers in order to judge. I don't like the judging. He's probably one of the most important contemporary calligraphers, yes. 3 years ago, I did a book called Signs of Our Times, where I included 50 artists who work on the base of calligraphists, who work with the words. And he was among the 50, there were only 50 calligraphers. And Hasan Masoudi is one of the five, somewhere from Iran and elsewhere, Egypt and elsewhere. But I think he's extremely important because already by 1980 in France, he had books published, which very few Arab or Iranian calligraphers had any book published then. So he made his name very well known right away in Paris where he went. And that were almost the very few books that were monographies that were available on any Arab artist, and certainly on a calligrapher, were his. And that's why he influenced many, many future calligraphers.
Mm-hmm. And one of them being El Seed. He said that Hasan Masoudi completely revolutionized the art of calligraphy. He said that it would be a little bit too much for anyone to say that that person is the greatest living calligrapher, etc. Do you think this is also a little bit of a stretch? Do you think he completely revolutionized the field?
I think he did revolutionize the field because he brought a new aesthetic to the traditional calligraphy. You know, a calligrapher is usually somebody with a traditional diploma on calligraphy. And contemporary artists, most of them don't want to be called calligraphers because what they do is to use the morphology of the letter rather than be excellent in calligraphy. What they want is a new aesthetic, a new visual, a new concept. But in the case of Hasan Masoudi, he managed to do that. He managed to do that very, very modestly. He had a very modest start, but he knew the importance of publication. He knew the importance of making his work available to others, and that's why he inspired so many artists. El Cid is one of them. El Cid was influenced by Hasan Masoudi, but also by Nja Mehdawi. For example, the artworks you see behind me is by Nja Mehdawi, where you cannot read any word. It's the opposite, a little bit, of Hasan Masoudi, where Hasan Masoudi takes inspiration from proverbs by Rumi, by Hafez, Saadi, French Saint-Exupéry, Khalil Gibran, etc., etc. He takes old and new, contemporary poets and old poets. So Hasan Masoudi has always something to say. He is an artist who uses his writing, and the writing can be not always, but most of the time, very readable. Excuse me. And he puts his, he conveys the message which touched him visually. Mm-hmm. So you have proverbs, you have short sentences, short poems that really moved him, and he wants to move us and educate us and bring a bit of wisdom to the world of we live in. I don't think he wants to compete in terms of conceptually or aesthetically, just that his calligraphy developed naturally with his effort, with some 40 years of career. I remember the first time I saw his book and I met him was 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm. You said that his career evolved naturally, but then he studied figurative painting. He's excellent in calligraphy, just like you said, in the traditional sense, but he also studied Western art. So how did this contribute to his art do you think, his calligraphy, his style?
I think the Western art, many artists from the Arab world and most of the developing countries have to come almost in Europe or America or somewhere in order to have Western art and have access to contemporary art scene. However, he found that very quickly, maybe because already the Iranian artists with La Maison de l'Iran in Paris and other art critics were influencing, that what is best is to be yourself. If you want to be unique, you cannot go. If you want to compete in figurative art, you have to compete with hundreds of Westerners, Brazilians, African, and others. While if you go to something that belongs to your culture, which is calligraphy, and the essence of the verb, the proverbs or the verb or the words of wisdom, then you become unique. And uniqueness is the important thing for an artist. I find him that he is an artist before and anything else, who uses calligraphy to express himself.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of a career or what kind of an artistic journey do you think he would have if he didn't leave Iraq?
You know, sometimes you find your country when you're outside of your country and you feel maybe it's a feeling of loss or a feeling of uniqueness. Maybe if he did calligraphy in Iraq, he wouldn't be unique because there are some 20 calligraphers in Iraq who are very good at the moment, or there were at that time. So if you want to be unique, you have to go out, you have to find your roots, but you have also to find the competitive scene of Western Europe or America or Canada or elsewhere or Australia. You have to compete with the rest of the world. And this is what makes you stand out. What makes him stand out as is nobody else is from Najaf, who does calligraphy, who lives in Paris, who has captured what can he translate in art, what can he express in art that is unique. Mm-hmm. And that to capture and to transmit that feeling is unique to him.
Okay, so we talked about how he influenced a generation of mostly calligraphy artists, I reckon. Who were his influences, you think? Was it only traditional calligraphy artists, or what would you say?
Yeah, I think it was the basis of it, because as I told you, I did a book with 50 artists who use calligraphy. Not all of them, almost five of them only said that they are a calligrapher. None of the others said they are a calligrapher. What he learned is that calligraphy is a technique. You have to go to schools and learn it from a master. But what he learned also, I think, by coming to Europe was having access to Chinese calligraphy, to Japanese, to big strokes, brushes, things that in the Middle East usually is limited to small paper or manuscripts. The calligraphy was always in small format. And suddenly Europe allowed him to see other cultures, whether Asian culture or European culture, and see bigger and in different format and support.
Okay, Rosa, it was lovely talking to you. Thanks a lot for joining us on Showcase today.
My pleasure. Thank you.